My dear students, I hope that you all are safe at home with your family. Welcome back to this online class learning. Welcome you all after this Ganpati vacation. Today we are going to learn an important topic. Myself, Johnsy teacher, is going to teach your grammar. In grammar, we are going to learn about modal auxiliary verbs, that is modal verbs. Modal auxiliary verbs looks confusing, but it is not as much as confusing or difficult to understand. It is very easy to understand. So let us first revise what we have learned in the previous grammar topic. Already we have studied about verbs. So let us revise what are verbs. Verbs are action words. Actions like swimming, dancing, talking, speaking, listening are all called as action verbs. Now there are three forms of verbs in grammar, that is V1 form, V2 form and V3 form. In V1 form, the base form of the verb will be given. In V2 form, the past form of the verb will be given. In V3 form, the ED or EN form of the verb will be given. For example, in the first, give is the base form of the verb. What is the past tense of give? That is gave. And in V3 it will come as given. Then second, eat. Eat, past tense is ate. And in V3 form it will come as eaten. Next, come is the base form. Past form is came. And in V3 form it will come as come only. Next, go. In past tense of go is went. And in V3 form, it will come as gone. Next, base form is clean. Past form will be as cleaned. And V3 form will be as cleaned. So, these are the V1, V2 and V3 forms. That is the three forms of the verb. And what we will learn today is that we will learn about two main parts of verbs. Then meaning of modal auxiliary verbs and the types of modal auxiliary verbs. So there are two types of verbs, that is main verbs and auxiliary verbs. Main verbs are those verbs, that is the action verbs. Action verbs, as we saw, that is swimming, cleaning, then washing, helping, then speaking, talking, listening, these all are called as main verbs. And today we are going to learn about auxiliary verbs, that is the helping verbs. So let us start with the topic. The first is we will study about the meaning of modal auxiliary verbs. Modal auxiliary verbs are also called as helping verbs. It gives more meaning to the main verb. Modal auxiliary verbs cannot stand alone. They require main verb for their existence. Whenever we use modal auxiliary verbs, verbs are used in first form of verb, that is the V1 base form. They require words like can, could, may, might, should, have to, ought to, would, will, must are modal auxiliary verbs. That is, the main verbs cannot stand alone without the modal auxiliary verbs. The sentences of modal auxiliary can be affirmative, it can be negative or interrogative. The form of modal auxiliary verb is subject plus V, modal auxiliary plus V1 plus object. The verb will always come in the base form. So this is what is called as modal auxiliary verbs. Now we will study about the types of modal auxiliary verbs. There are six types of modal auxiliary verbs. They are ability, permission, advice, obligation or compulsion, possibility, and the sixth type is request. So we will study about these six types now one by one with the examples. So let us start with the first type, that is the ability. The modal auxiliary verb ability means the capacity or the skills to do something. Words like can, could, be able to, could have are used. For example, he could run fast when he was young. In this sentence, we can see that could is a modal auxiliary verb showing ability. Then second one, they could have come to the picnic. Could have is showing us the modulary auxiliary verb, that is ability. My brother can speak French well. Can is a verb that is showing is a modal auxiliary verb which is showing the which is showing ability. And the fourth example is Sheila is able to come to the party tonight. So is able to is a modal auxiliary verb showing ability. So here in these sentences we can see that there are helping verbs, that is could have, can, is able to. These are called as modal auxiliary verbs. And there is another verbs that is called as main verbs, that is run, come, speak and come. This run, come, speak, come is in V1 form. So now in the first sentence can we say he run fast when he was young? No, we cannot say like that. We need a helping verb with that. So if we put a correct helping verb, then the sentence will be correct. So this is what is called as modal auxiliary verb about ability. Now we will learn about the second type, that is permission. Permission modal auxiliary verb means the action of allowing someone to do a particular thing. Words like can, may, could are used. Everyone knows what is a permission. So in this permission modal auxiliary verb, it means to ask or to allow someone to do a particular thing. For example, can I call you tomorrow? So here can is a permission. It's showing a permission of modal auxiliary verb. Now in this first sentence, without can I write like that, I call you tomorrow? No, the sentence does not make any sense. So we have to use a helping verb, then only the sentence will be complete and in a complete sense. Now second one, could I open the window? Here could is a modal auxiliary verb which is showing permission. Third one, may I borrow your dictionary? May is a modal auxiliary verb which is showing us permission. So this is what is called as permission. Now we will study about the third type of modal auxiliary verb, that is request. Request modal auxiliary verb means an act of asking politely for something. When we ask something politely, that is called as request. Words like can, could, will, would are used. For example, can you please pass me that book? This is a request. We are requesting, can you please pass me that book? So can is a modal auxiliary verb showing request. Now second one, would you help me carry this heavy bags? So would is a modal auxiliary verb showing request. Third one, could you bring some vegetables from the market? Could is a modal auxiliary verb showing request. And the fourth one is, will you make a copy of this essay for me? Will is a modal auxiliary verb showing request. So in these sentences, can, would, could, will is a modal auxiliary verb showing request. Now request means what? We have to ask politely. Can we ask like that, can you please pass me that book? No, we cannot ask very harshly. In request, we have to ask politely, then only it will be granted. Now the fourth type of modal auxiliary verb is possibility. Possibility modal auxiliary verb means the state or fact of being possible or the thing that may happen. Means it is a possibility shows that the things may happen. It is a possibility of things to happen. Words like may, might, could are used. For example, we may not participate in the dance competition. Your may is a modal auxiliary verb showing possibility. We may not, that means we can, we may also, and we may not also. That is a possibility. Then second, we might go to Mathera next week. This sentence, this is showing that we might go also and we might not go also. That means when we are in a decision that we are confused about a particular thing, that whether we have to go or not, that shows the possibility. Now, might is a modal auxiliary verb showing possibility. Now, third one, that story could be true. Who knows? Could is a modal auxiliary verb showing possibility. Now, here in this sentence, the story could be true or could not be true also. We don't know that it can be true also and it cannot be true also. So, this is called as possibility. Possibility means when we are confused about a particular thing or about whether to go or no. When we are confused, then it shows the possibility modal auxiliary verb. Now the fifth type of modal auxiliary verb is obligation or compulsion. Obligation or compulsion modal auxiliary verb refers to an act of action to which a person is under compulsion or legally bound duty or commitment. So obligation modal auxiliary verb shows when we are under compulsion. If suppose a teacher tells you to compulsory complete your book, then it is a compulsion. Or suppose if you have committed to someone that tomorrow I will meet you. So this is a commitment that surely I will meet you tomorrow. So this is called as obligation or compulsion modal auxiliary verb. Words like must, have to, need to are used. For example, you need to study hard or else you will fail. So need to is showing the obligation or compulsion modal auxiliary verb. Your need to means that means you have to study hard, otherwise you will fail. So this is a compulsion. Second one, we mustn't spit on the road. So mustn't is a modal auxiliary verb showing obligation or compulsion. Mustn't, that means over here it is showing a duty. It is showing the duty that we must not spit on the road. Then third one, y'all must follow the rules and regulations of the school. Y'all must follow the rules and regulations of the school. That is the duty. It is the duty of the students to follow the rules and regulations of the school. So must is a obligation or compulsion modal auxiliary verb. And the fourth example is, children have to arrive on time at school. So here have to is a compulsion modal auxiliary verb, which is showing the compulsion that children have to arrive on time. So these are the four examples of obligation and obligation or compulsion. Now the next one, that is advice or suggestion. Now advice or suggestion. Advice means what? Giving an advice to someone that you should not go there. It is not good for you. You should not eat healthy foods. It is not good for you. So this is all called as advice or suggestion. Suggestion when we are in a problem. So we need some suggestions to get out from that. So that is called as suggestion. Now let us see what is the meaning of advice or suggestion modal auxiliary verb. Advice or suggestion modal auxiliary verb refers to guidance or giving counseling. So guidance, when we want some guidance, suppose after 10th we are very confused that which field we should go. So then we need some guidance or we need some counseling. So that is called as advice or suggestion modal auxiliary verb. Words like should, ought to, shall are used. For example, young children shouldn't use mobile phone. So this is an advice that young children shouldn't use mobile phone. Otherwise, their eyes will get spoiled in a very little age. So shouldn't is showing the advice or suggestion modal auxiliary verb. Then second one, you ought to go to the doctor. So this also example shows the suggestion that you ought to go to the doctor because you're not feeling well. So that's why you ought to go to the doctor. Or maybe some other reasons also. So ought to is a advice or suggestion modal auxiliary verb. Third one, you shall go to the counselor and take best suggestions. So this is a suggestion. Shall is showing a suggestion, that is advice or suggestion modal auxiliary verb. And fourth one, everyone should exercise regularly. So everyone should exercise regularly. This sentence shows the advice that if you exercise regularly, then what will happen? You will remain fit and you will remain very fine. Your diseases will not attack you. So this should is a advice or suggestion, modulary a modal auxiliary verb. So this is called as modal auxiliary verb, means to give guidance or give a suggestion. And the last one is certainty. Now certainty means what? Certainly I will do this. Certainly means we have a firm confidence in ourselves that we will certainly do this. Let us see what is given. Certainty modal auxiliary verb refers to firm confidence in doing something. We will means suppose you want to achieve something. So what you will tell? I will achieve my goal. I will surely achieve my goal. So this is a certainty. Yes, surely I will achieve my goal. So words like will, might, may are used. For example, I will achieve my goal. Will is a verb showing certainty modal auxiliary verb. Second one, she will not come to school tomorrow as she is not feeling well. So this is the sentence which showing certainty. Yes, tomorrow I will not come to school because I'm not feeling well. So that now that will not is showing the certainty modal auxiliary verb. As I said before, only that modal auxiliary verb can be negative also, and it can be positive, negative, or it can be interrogative also. Then for third one is they might be at the park. So might be, this is a certainty. Yes, they might be at the park. So might is showing the certainty modal auxiliary verb. And fourth one, you may choose any subject that you like best. So this is certainty that you may choose any subject that you like best. So may is showing the certainty modal auxiliary verb. So students, these are the different types of modal auxiliary verbs that we have studied today. So students, I hope that you have understood this modal auxiliary verbs and their different types. So let us do a quick revision of what we have studied about the types of modal auxiliary verbs. That is, we have studied about ability, permission, advice, obligation, compulsion, possibility, request, and one more thing was that certainty. So these are the seven types that we have studied. So what we have learned, students, we have learned about the meaning of modal auxiliary verbs. Then we have learned about the different types of modal auxiliary verbs, that is the ability, permission, request, possibility, obligation or compulsion, advice or suggestion, and certainty. So students, I hope that you have understood this topic well. So whatever doubts students you have, you can ask me in Zoom lecture. So thank you students. Take care of yourselves. Stay safe and stay healthy. And we will meet soon.